We all know and love the story of Rocky Balboa, played by Sylvester Stallone and directed by John Avildsen, an underdog from Philadelphia who gets the chance to fight the boxing champion Apollo Creed, played by Carl Weathers. These interesting facts show a new viewpoint of the movie, like the fact that Rocky Balboa was at one point an anti-hero. In one of the most memorable scenes from the movie, where Rocky is running through a street in Philadelphia, Rocky gets tossed in orange. Everyone thought that part would have been scripted, as a symbol of the people from Philadelphia cheering on Rocky. But the man who threw the orange was actually not an actor, and didn't know anything about the movie. In fact, everyone in the crowd had no idea. They sure must have been confused when some guy kept running through the street with a van following him. You can see the reactions of the people looking at Rocky, and those would be authentic reactions. We all love Rocky's charm and heart that his character has, but what if his likable character from the original script was not a likable character? That's right, Rocky was supposed to be an anti-hero. The scriptwriter for the movie, Stallone, said, "The character was a very dark, as a matter of fact, he throws the fight at the very end." So much for never giving up and making the distance, the phrase has been so popular with Rocky. The reason Rocky throws the fight is because he didn't want to be involved in this kind of world. Rocky said, "I would rather just be who I was, and just have all this hatred around me." A very dark movie that would have been definitely not the Hollywood blockbuster that it came to be today. Luckily, Stallone's then wife, Sasha Zak, said, "Oh, I don't like it. Rocky seems so nasty." So Stallone went back and rewrote the script. Rather than have a cinematic downer movie as popular with other movies in the 70s, Stallone went the other way, offering audiences a more lighthearted character. So thank you, Sasha, for criticizing the movie, or else it would have been a complete disaster. The location of Philadelphia was a hard one for the crew. Plus, with the budget of around $1 million, the crew couldn't afford catering or trailers. All exterior shots were lit exclusively with natural light, and pizza was the only on-set meal for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Trains can be seen rolling in the background in exterior shots throughout the movie. A nice little detail to bring the noise and busyness that Philadelphia has. This was no accident, of course. But the crazy thing is, with such a low budget, the crew couldn't hire a train to go through the shot. Instead, a production assistant would stand near the tracks with a walkie-talkie, and would tell Avildsen when the trains were coming so he could shout action. Instead of an ice rink, Rocky and Adrian's first date was originally set in a restaurant. However, the restaurant wouldn't happen until later in the series. Avildsen told Stallone to rewrite it so the characters would be moving around. Stallone revised it as an ice skating scene that was supposed to include hundreds of extras. However, the budget wouldn't allow for extras, ice skates, or stunt people, so that is why they make the ice rink closed so that no one would be in it. It is romantic in a weird way to see Rocky walking along with Adrian instead of skating, but this would be done because Stallone didn't ice skate. Stallone says, "I don't know why I wrote it." The scene was salvaged when Avildsen suggested Rocky and Adrian take to the ice alone, and that Rocky jog along while she skated. When Rocky eats the raw egg in the cup, everyone would cringe. Eating raw eggs is obviously bad nowadays, but back in the 70s, it was seen as a quick and easy way to get protein, and many bodybuilders ate raw eggs. Stallone was able to easily down raw eggs before the training montage because it was something he'd done while living in a tiny New York apartment that didn't have a stove. Originally, the cinematic fight wasn't choreographed, but when Stallone and Weathers got together for their first rehearsal, confusion reigned. Avildsen asked Stallone to map out each punch of the fight, and the next day, he had more than a dozen pages of lefts and rights written out. The actor rehearsed that like a dance for weeks, referring at times to their footage of their rehearsals to see what needed to change. In the original ending, Apollo is carried out of the ring in celebration, and Rocky and Adrian retreat to the exit of the stadium. The shot of them holding hands and walking into the darkness would be cut out of the final movie with the ending changed, but they still decide to keep the concept and use it as the movie's poster. When Paulie throws the turkey out of the house, the leg was detached from the turkey from retakes having to be done. Paulie kept throwing the leg and eating it, was not part of the original script, but with it detached, they decided to add the scene that we ended up getting now. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe so you can see more facts and behind the scenes of your favorite movies.